OpenAI Agent Builder just got even more powerful overnight. The team have been cooking, my video went viral on Monday, and now I want to show you one automation to rule them all and an easy way to get started with Agent Builder. Let's dive in. By the way, I'll be doing more videos on Agent Builder on this channel, so if you want to see them, subscribe. Okay, if you've never used Agent Builder before, it's really simple, and I'll link it up down below. You just click Create a Workflow. And for this first simple workflow, all we're going to do is change the instructions to our first agent and add one tool over here. We'll leave everything else as default, so under the instructions where I say you are a helpful assistant, I'm also going to add in these custom instructions. You will use a free-to-use API to get the weather for the location that the user enters. Okay, that's done. That's really simple, but how do we get that weather information at the moment? The AI will probably hallucinate. Well, this is where we'll add a tool, and we're going to add an MCP server. You may remember that I did a video about this and it was broken. Well, now it works and it makes it super powerful. I'm going to be using Zapier for the MCP server. This gives Agent Builder superpowers. We'll click down here, get API key. You will need a Zapier account. It'll take you to your logged in Zapier account where you'll create a new MCP. You'll choose from the MCP client OpenAI API right here. You can give it a friendly name like Weather MCP and create. Next, we're going to add a tool. And for this, we're actually going to use Webhooks. And I'll show you why this is really powerful in a moment. I'm just going to add the get webhook because we're only getting information at the moment. Next, we'll go back over to connect and we'll copy the API key secret right here. Our job is now done in Zapier. Let's go back to Agent Builder. So you'll see I've called it Weather MCP here, paste in the API key, connect, and there we go. We're done. It's as simple as that. Now, just to make sure it only uses the webhook tool, I'm going to disable the access to the other tools and click add. That's it. It was as simple as that to build our first agent inside OpenAI Agent Builder. Now let's test it and see if it works. And in order to test an agent with external tools, you just go up here to the top and you'll click preview. Now down here, I will simply test the workflow by saying, get the weather for Paphos, Cyprus. There we go. That looks like a good request. Let's hit enter and you'll see my agent goes straight to work. Now it's going to do a little bit of reasoning, figuring out that it's got the Zapier MCP, and it did that very quickly. It figured out what API it needs to call. Bear in mind, I didn't tell it what API to call. It just made it up and I can approve it. Now the agent has noticed that there was a problem with the first call, so it troubleshoots by itself and I can approve again. One more time. This time my agent has made a call and it's preparing the response. It was successful on this attempt at getting the weather from that free API. And look at this, it's actually pulled in the correct weather for Paphos, telling me that it's currently 22.2 degrees Celsius, a bunch of other info, and I got the details I needed. Now, if you've put two and two together already, I think you're probably seeing the power of this. I set up one MCP, that's a connection to Zapier's webhooks, and then my OpenAI agent discovered the API it needed to call, then it self-improved, it got the correct API call, got the details back, and gave me the answer. So if you like what you see so far, throw a like and subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. Okay, that's great and all that, and I can go in here and I can rename this to be my weather agent that I can call on anytime. And the best thing about this is I can go up to the code up here and I can create a widget with ChatKit so you can interact with it, which is really, really cool. But I can also take the code, and if I was vibe coding an app, this agent could sit right inside my app and I could have the most overpowered weather app ever. But I'm not satisfied with a simple weather agent. I'm going to create a new one. We'll go into agent instructions. Your job is to search the web for an open and free to use API to get the data the user wants. You will then create short, concise documentation on how the API works and how to call it correctly. That's a Giga prompt there, isn't it? Now, we're not going to give it an MCP tool, most importantly, right now. All we're going to do is give it the ability to conduct a web search. You'll see the option to search the web is right there. So I'm adding that tool in here, and I'm going to leave all of the configuration here blank. And now I'll go up here and rename my agent to be Giga Agent, or Jarvis if you prefer. Now with this setup, I'm just going to click down to more, and this is really important. I'm going to untick display response in chat. Now that's because I don't want to confuse the user with APIs. That's an under-the-hood technical term that allows my agent to receive data from pretty much anywhere in real time. With that done, I'll name the agent API Master. And now we'll go ahead and connect a brand new node. And this node will be another agent. This will be the end agent that will respond to our user. Your job is to use the below documented API to return an answer to the user's question. And with that, you'll say, well, hang on, Mike, how does it know what the API is? Well, you'll see here, as we give instructions to our agent, we can add context. And look at this, API master will have an output. We pass that along from this agent to this new agent we're creating that will eventually go and call that API using MCP. All done, let's connect Zapier MCP just as we did before. So I added the details in Agent Builder, but most importantly, back over here in Zapier, in my MCP, I can look for webhooks again, and then I can add them. But this time, rather than just adding get, I'll add everything, all webhooks by Zapier tools. Now, just a quick disclaimer here, use this with caution because post and put webhooks actually allow your agent to write data to the web. If you're only looking to receive data from the web, just stick with a get webhook. Okay, you'll see four tools here, and if I pop them open, put, post, get, and even custom requests when APIs get tricky. I really have set my agent up for success here. Let's test it out. Let's try weather again, get the weather for Madrid. And it knows that it needs to search, and it's already found exactly the same API that my previous agent used. And now it's searching the web to make sure it's got the up-to-date docs for that API. And now you can see it's putting together concise documentation, and you'll see my MCP agent now has best practice. So remember last time we took three attempts, this should take one attempt. There we go, and you'll see with just one shot, it's got the temperature, partly cloudy, the wind speed, the humidity, all because it was using the correct documentation for this API. So now you can see the power, let's give it another test. And we'll just ask it to get the current price of Bitcoin. API master spinning back into action. It needs to find a free to use API. It seems to have found an API, searching the web to confirm documentation. It's searching a bit more. And while this is going, you can see the power of this. If you need to build apps with APIs or even MCPs built in, you could do MCP inception and get MCPs to research other MCPs. Okay, it's done a lot of searching the web this time, and it's crafted what exactly it needs. It's got all the endpoints ready to pass on to my worker agent, the little workhorse that's actually going to go ahead and get the real-time price of Bitcoin. It's got a webhook here, let's approve. Straight off to Zapier to execute that webhook, and a pretty accurate real-time pricing of Bitcoin, at least at the time I recorded this video. All right, I'm feeling confident now. Let's try something a little harder. Find the latest posts on X about Agent Builder and summarize the sentiment. This is going to be a bit harder because X doesn't have a free API. I wonder if it'll find a workaround. It's looking for something. It's found something called Knitter and RSS Hub, and it seems to be searching more. This is cool. It's actually finding a way to grab real-time data from X. Lots and lots of web searches being conducted. Okay, I think it's actually found an API it can use to get some kind of data. It says there's no official free X API for keyword search anymore, but it's found some alternatives. It's posted them all out here, and it's now trying to pass that info to my agent. Well, would you believe it? Look at this. It's constructed a webhook. Is it going to work? And what do you know? It actually says in its thoughts that it's got a set of items. It's summarizing the sentiment. And now it's coming right back to me with an answer. Here's what X is saying about Agent Builder right now. It's got a positivity, a neutral, and a negative score. And it does indeed cite OpenAI's Agent Builder. And it does correctly say exactly what it is and how people are talking about it. Now it's actually linking to some statuses. Okay, I wonder how recent these statuses are. Is this real or is this hallucinated? Now is the time to find out. Let's click a link here. And oh my goodness me, that is accurate. That is incredibly accurate. Literally, the time I'm recording this video, this was posted out 30 minutes ago. Wow. My API master agent has found a way to get real-time data from X. It took seconds, even though there's no official free API that can do it. This is just incredible. Find me trending tools on Product Hunt today, released around AI agents, and rank them from most to least buzz. API master is thinking how it's going to do this and searching the web for docs. You'll see this very specific search for Product Hunt API free access unauthenticated. Okay, it's done all of its research. It's passed it on to my main agent, and now it's following the instructions. In this case, it said if I can share a temporary token to access this API, it will give me a proper list. But if I prefer not, it can actually write me a script to run locally to get that data. Pretty cool stuff. And if I were working with APIs and wanted latest best practices, this agent is going to be invaluable for me. As I'm really tempted to find out if this works, I'll follow the link to see if I can get a token. Okay, look at this. I got myself a token, so let's copy it. And I'll hand this over to my AI agent. Pretty exciting. Now, to be clear, I wouldn't usually post an API token into a clear AI chat, but this is just for testing. Okay, it's thanking me very much. My agent is now working away on this with my token. And look at this, within moments, I've got today's trending product hunt tools related to AI agents, ranked by buzz and score, and it's said votes plus three times comments. And it's actually pulled in all the data here from Product Hunt using the API. This stuff is really cool. And of course, now I want to hand this agent over to you. So I'm going to go ahead and open source this. I will go up here to the publish button and we'll publish Giga Agent. Okay, that's done. I really like the way OpenAI gives it version control so I can always roll back if things break. And now you'll see it appears in my active workflows here with drafts over here and access to templates as well. Now, sadly, I can't share that exact template with you. OpenAI doesn't allow me to do that presently, but I think that would be a great new feature for Agent Builder to have. Sharing templates with other users would be really cool. So there you go. And don't worry, if you really want to set this up for yourself, I'm going to put copy and paste instructions into my community, which I'll link up down below. And you can simply rip those instructions, paste them into your own agent builder, and start using Giga Agent to unpack APIs and access open real-time data all over the web. And it's such an exciting concept that I just can't get my head fully around the potential use cases for this. But I think that OpenAI Agent Builder combined with the Zapier MCP is an overpowered combination. I hope you enjoy using it as much as I've enjoyed making the video about it. Thank you so much for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next.